worthwhile. It's a beautiful world we live in. Give your brother a smile.
This is Alpha Dog, and you're listening to The Andy Ball Show, only on Spreaker.com.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, my name is Andy Bond, and we are back with the two greatest guys in the history of Wisconsin here. One from Wisconsin and one from, I have no clue where he is.
Arkansas.
What?
Arkansas.
One from Wisconsin and one from Arkansas. Edward Stone and Grandpa Al, what is up? How are you doing?
I'm doing my own high fives.
So, speaking of iHeart, has anybody ever made it on iHeart here?
I don't want to.
How? I'm just wondering how Deshaun Porter got on iHeart. I'm seriously, how?
Because he doesn't. He definitely posts his picture and keeps everything clean and doesn't do all the swearing and this and that and everything else. And they like that. Plus, he also follows the rules. I don't like following the rules, so I will not do iHeart.
Same here. I love playing music. I cannot do 30 seconds of music. I'm sorry. I can't. I love playing full songs. I cannot talk 5 hours. Holy cow. I cannot believe that Deshaun Porter made it on iHeart. I am so impressed with them. Holy cow, that's cool. So that is...
I just want to talk to him because, you know, I've got the same problem he has. He's, you know, mostly legally blind. And I wanted to get some pointers on how to do stuff.
Let me email him right now.
Very carefully.
Well, while I Skype him, just a minute. Okay, I got it. Wow, Deshaun Porter, holy cow, that's cool. Well, someone is in my chat room. What is up? Debbie helped Deshaun get on iHeart. Oh, that is cool. Well, breaking news out of my show, Deshaun Porter got on iHeartRadio. I cannot believe it. That is really good. I am so proud of him right now because he keeps it clean. He keeps it good. And you know what? Between me and him, I don't keep it clean. I cannot keep it clean. I'm sorry. There is no way I cannot keep it clean.
Well, I can keep it clean by taking a shower, but that's as far as I go.
Oh, me too. I can take a shower too, but I cannot keep it clean. But how the heck do I get on iHeart? I've been trying to apply to that thing for a whole mess of time, and I cannot get on iHeart to save my soul. How does people get onto iHeart?
Just they have a lot of drama. Yeah. Avoid the drama. Definitely.
Yep.
Tell everybody that you're a prince of goodwill and say, hey, I will not have drama on my thing. So anybody else that wants to start drama, slap them and tell them to go away.
Oh, yeah. Trust me, we have been doing that. I have people in my chat room policing my chat room every single time when drama occurs. They're just coming up to my show and they're typing on my in my chat saying, please ban this son of a gun. Okay. I have people policing my show every 5 seconds, so I'm glad. I love it. That's how you keep the drama away. Have Speaker Police police your show, ladies and gentlemen. What, you never knew a guy got people in my back pocket here? You did not know that? I have the Spreaker Navy SEALs, baby, and the police on my side.
Cool.
So...
I got 11 minutes left in my show.
And I just started a brand new one, so we're good.
Oh, cool.
This is the Spreaker News. My name is Andy Bond, and welcome to the Spreaker News. We are live from the Green Bay Studios with Grandpa Al and Ed and Southern Cowboy in the Spreaker News newsroom here. So what is up in Kenosha, Wisconsin? What's the latest news in Kenosha at Grandpa Al?
Well, it's about 53 degrees outside, nice and sunny. It makes me look like I don't know what the hell I'm doing, but that's all right. That's usually the case. And I have a lot of great people out there. I got Amanda B. She's listening. We got that wonderful Patty. She's been listening. And Apocalypse, he's been there. And I'm just sitting here talking to you people and trying to figure out why am I here when I should be outside.
I have no clue why you're here too, ladies and gentlemen. Well, Diamond Nikki is in the house, or aka Nikki. What's up, Nikki? How are you doing? Well, this chat room is now coming into my in the neck of the woods here. People are slowly coming into my chat room. I'm sorry, people are slowly coming into my chat room. It only takes about 5 seconds.
Grandpa? Huh? How come you ain't got my name on there no more?
I was going to, but you took I made the day with the Wounded Warriors for today and tomorrow, and then next week. I'm definitely thinking about going 3 days a week, and we are going to have a special show together. Most of it is going to be your type of music. You're going to give me a list, and I'm going to be putting it out there.
Well, all I can tell you is country.
Yes, it is. Country. Hey, I love country, too.
Cool.
I love country music.
I like country, too. I mean, I like the oldies, like the 60s, 70s, and 80s country. But I also like the upbeat country, like the Georgia Boys. You know, something with a new beat. Know what I mean?
Yeah.
Yes, I know what you mean.
I like to get some hillbilly music in here.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, you're in luck. This next song is, if you're going to play in Texas, you got to have a fiddling band. This is going out to Dallas, Texas, and the Country Lovers. Here it is. If you're going to play in Texas, you got to have a fiddling band. This is the Andy Bond Show saying, rock on.
If you're gonna play in Texas, you gotta have a fiddle in the band. That lead guitar is hot, but not for Louisiana man. So rosin up that bow for faded love and let's all dance. If you're gonna play in Texas, you gotta have a fiddle in the band. I remember down in Houston, we were putting on a show, when a cowboy in the back stood up and yelled, "Hot Night Joe!" He said, "We love what you're doing, boys, don't get us wrong. There's just something missing in your song. If you're gonna play in Texas, you gotta have a fiddle in the band. That lead guitar is hot, but not for Louisiana man. So rosin up that bow for faded love and let's all dance. If you're gonna play in Texas, you gotta have a fiddle in the band." So we dusted off our boots and put our cowboy hats on straight. Them Texans raised the roof when Jeff opened up his case. You say y'all all want a two-step. You say you want a do-si-do. Well, here's a fiddling song before we go. If you're gonna play in Texas, you gotta have a fiddle in the band. That lead guitar is hot, but not for Louisiana man. So rosin up that bow for faded love and let's all dance. If you're gonna play in Texas, you gotta have a fiddle in the band. Thank you.
play in Texas, you gotta have a fiddle in the band. That lead guitar is hot, but not for Louisiana man. So raw's enough that both are paid in love, and let's all dance. If you're gonna play in Texas, you gotta have a fiddle in the band.
This is Alpha Dog, and you're listening to The Andy Bong Show, only on Spreaker.com.
Would be mad, wouldn't take it any more, hoping he was, it wasn't so.
What is up? We are back on the Spreaker News team. My name is Andy Bond, and yep. That was, if you're going to play in Texas, you got to have a fiddle in a band. That was for Edward Stone right there, ladies and gentlemen. We have Grandpa Al, and this is, like I said, this is Spreaker News, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back. How are you doing, gentlemen?
I'm a good dude. I'm almost at the end of my show, so I'm going to give out the shout-outs and then go from there. I've got a minute and 26 seconds left on the song, and then 3 minutes and 30 seconds on the show.
Ah, cool. I cannot wait. So, ladies and...
Nice.
What?
I was asking Grandpa who's coming on next. Ain't it Pumpkin?
Pumpkin Face, 5 o'clock at the Sublimination Station.
Wow.
This is maybe their pride. I was worried. Man, it was so
Oh, don't worry about it. Everybody, heck, don't worry about it. Everybody wants to do something nice for the Rooney Warriors project.
Okay, I've got 43 seconds left.
Well,
sure. And say my goodbyes and say, God bless you all and everything. Something like that.
I know what we could do. Instead of me shaving, I'm going to put Andy on the block and make him shave from head to toe.
Oh, what? Seriously? No way, Jose.
20 seconds.
No way, Amazon. You're not going to let me shave. I don't think people would like me when I shave.
9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And we're back on live. Right now we have Ed Stowe, the Southern Cowboy, and Andy Bong on his show doing with us on the Saturday Wounded Warrior Salute. And I've got about a minute left, so I'm saying thank you so much, Amanda B. Yes, and Edward, would you like to say something to Amanda?
Thank you, Amanda, and I know I'm not mad at you.
Just share some boot shine with you and see which one you get drunk first.
There you go. It says, Andy, would you like to say something to our listeners?
Well, from the Andy Bond Show, thank you so much for supporting the Ruin Warriors Project. My name is Andy Bond, and from the bottom of the Spreaker News team and everybody that is working so hard behind the scenes, that makes me look good. I'm just joking. Yeah, seriously, it does. From the booth behind the scenes that are making me look good, telling me what to say, posting me up. Thank you so much from the bottom of my heart. Tune in tomorrow. Tune in tomorrow at 10 o'clock p.m. When the 24-hour telethon kicks off into high gear. That's right, ladies and gentlemen. I'm gonna be listening to the 24-hour telethon, and maybe, just maybe, you will see me on the telethon doing a 3 to 6 o'clock a.m. show, music show. Who knows if I can get up that early? If I can get up. God help me if I can. But anyway, tune in tomorrow, because at 10 o'clock p.m., the telethon of the Ruin Warriors Project kicks off. So from the Andy Bond Show saying, goodbye, peace out, love ya.
Take care, God bless, be well, and may the good Lord always take you and keep you safe. Peace.
Y'all come back now here.
Yep.
Come back now. Bye.
Later, taters. And we are gone.
And now we are on the Spreaker News team here, ladies and gentlemen. And now the Pungent Face is going to do some... I can't wait. It's going to be interesting. Pungent Face always does some cool shows, don't you think?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Definitely.
He's not one of those guys that plan everything out. It's like goes on a whim. Right?
I would like to go on a whim once in a while. Maybe it'll brace up my life.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, my name is Andy Bond, and we're just having some fun here. We're going to play some more music. I'm going to be talking about Spreaker news. Big news out of the Spreaker world is Deshaun Porter is now on iHeartRadio. Okay, that is really, really breaking news. In other news, Everstone got battery in his face. Note to self: do not use car batteries. That's what Everstone said on my other show. Do not use a car battery, okay? And the Wisconsin home front, Governor Scott Walker is still being stupid and not giving us plans for the brand new casino in Kenosha, Wisconsin. We have more. We're gonna have more news after this. After words from our sponsor.
Be nice. Say thank you. Once in a while, it's a beautiful world we live in. Give your brother a smile.
This is Alpha Dog, and you're listening to The Andy Bong Show, only on Spreaker.com.
Wonderful, don't smoke, don't litter, don't step on a beetle or ant. Always work on the sidewalk, never tread on the grass.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are back, and we're gonna take a short commercial break. We're gonna play all country music for Everstone today, so I have country music lined up from the get-go here, because I'm a big country fan. So today, in honor of, because I know that I'm gonna forget tomorrow here, but in honor of Everstone here, in honor of the recovery, we're gonna play all country music. So here it is, Big and Rich, Save a Horse, Ride a Cowboy. We'll be back on the Andy Bond Show.
Dum da dum da dum da dum da 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 dum da dum da dum da dum da 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 da. Out $100 bills, and it kills and it thrills like the horns on my Silverado grill. And I buy the bar a double round of Crown, and everybody's getting down in this town. Ain't never gonna be the same, 'cause I saddle up my horse and I ride into the city. I make a lot of noise, 'cause the girls, they are so pretty. Riding up and down Broadway on my old Studley Roy. Save a horse, ride a cowboy. Everybody says, save a horse. bling blinging while the girls are drinking. Long necks down, and I wouldn't trade old Leroy or my Chevrolet for your Escalade or your Freak Parade. But I'm the only John Wayne left in this town. When I saddle up my horse and I ride into the city, I make a lot of noise, cause the girls, they are so pretty. Riding up and down Broadway on my old stud Leroy, and the girls say, save a horse, ride a cowboy. Everybody says, save a horse, ride a cowboy. Thoroughbred, that's what she said in the back of my truck bed as I was getting buzzed on suds out on some back country road. We were flying high, fine as wine, having ourselves a big and rich time, and I was going just about as far as she'd let me go. But her evaluation of my cowboy reputation had me begging for salvation all night long. So I took her out gigging frogs, introduced her to my old bird dog, and sang her every Willie Nelson song I can think of, and we made love. Then I saddle up my horse and I ride into the city. I make a lot of noise, cause the girls, they are so pretty. Riding up and down Broadway on my old stud Leroy, and the girls say, save a horse, ride a cowboy. Everybody says,
be nice, say thank you, please, once in a while. It's a beautiful world we live in. Give your brother a smile.
This is Alpha Dog, and you're listening to The Andy Bong Show, only on Spreaker.com.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, we are back. Ladies and gentlemen, my name is Andy Barney, and that promo is courtesy of Alpha Dog. Thank you, Alpha Dog, so much for what you do for my show. We are live from the Green Bay Studios. We are talking about, we're going to dim it down a little bit, and if you don't like what we're hearing, change the channel, literally. I'm not kidding you. This is for not the faint of heart.
What? Hold on. Yeah, I'm going to go see if I can get a hold of Pumpkin Face on his show.
All right, bro. You have yourself a good one.
All right, you too. Y'all have fun.
Okay, bye.
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 Peace.
It's one of those good things that we all have to deal with. Oh, I love it.
Yep.
Such a wonderful person.
Uh-huh. Anyway, we're going to be talking about how porn videos are newsing with innocent people.
How are they being used against innocent people when it's a thing of supposed to be a lesson in love and everything else like that? But the problem is, they are all actors.
Yeah, but they don't understand that they're actors. They get paid to be rough. They get paid to have rough sex. They get paid to do it. But people that does it, people that do it to innocent girls, they should get shot and hung. I'm sorry. But I understand that they are paid actors. Porn stars are paid actors. Do you know how much porn stars get?
No, I don't. How much do they get?
$5,000 per scene. $5,000.
Wow.
That's a nice chunk of change. And if I was in California and I was desperate for money, of course I would be a porn star. I'm sorry. Could you just see me in a porn video?
I don't know. I'll probably close my eyes and just imagine it's somebody that I know, probably my wife, when she was younger, because I wouldn't touch her when she's this way, but that's okay. It's all in good fun.
Yeah, anyway, but I don't think I would be a good porn star, because you know what? I have a lot of respect for girls, and plus, I can't do what girls do. Like, they get into it. Like, if you get seriously, if you pay a girl $5, they will literally get into it. Literally, I'm not kidding you. Girls get into this crap, and guys don't.
$5? Man, what a cheap date.
You know what I mean. Yeah. Girl, you know what I mean.
Yes.
People would do anything for money. Basically, yeah.
Most people, yeah.
Most types of people will do anything for money. But
I would never do anything for money, ever. I've got morals that are well ahead of the standards that everybody else says. Oh, I'll give you $5 million if you do this for me again with my wife and everything else. So, yeah, well, you better save your money because... I'm not that way. I respect your wife.
Uh-huh. I respect everybody else. But you know what? There are some guys that would do horrible things to their wives, their spouse, their girlfriends. All because they saw it on a stinking porn video.
Oh, yeah.
And you know, it's like, what the heck are you doing? Why is it so important for people to watch this crap? I understand that if you want to get off on some girl... some guy jacking some girl off, go right ahead. I don't care. Whatever pleases your boat. Seriously, I'm not kidding you. But when you start doing that to a girl, the same thing what porn stars do to the guys, like, really rough, that's where I draw the line, and that's where I get stinking mad, because I hate when I read the newspapers, and it does like this. Well, today, a man was arrested because she was beating his wife. And when the man had this to say, I saw it on a porn video and it works. Why couldn't when the guy hit the girl, she obeyed him. Why can't it work in real life? That's what the guy said. And basically, I hate when people say that porn made me do this or the devil made me do this.
Yeah, it's when you want to bitch slap them and say...
You just want to go to their town and punch the living daylights out of them, and you don't care who you... If you get thrown in jail, you just want to punch the living daylights out of them, because everybody... I hate when people say, oh, the devil made me do it, or the porn video made me do it, porn stars made me do it. Seriously, get a stinking life, man, and own up to your mistakes.
Amen.
If you see a girl, you know what? And this is why I hate when guys talk in the locker room. Trust me, I hear y'all guys talking in the locker room saying, man, did you hear this? I knocked this chick up last night. Oh, it was so much fun. And you just wanna, literally, I heard that in a locker room once. And I was so, the teacher knew that I was so mad. The teacher called me in and saying, Andy, you gotta relax, Andy, relax. Because I was so close to punching the living daylights out of that guy.
Well, that's the kind of guy that does need to be punched out.
Yeah, because it's unfair. Why is it that every single time when you see it on the news, a girl gets raped because of porn? You can trace it back to porn. You can, I'm sorry. I don't care if a guy, I don't care if you get off on a guy jacking a girl. I don't mind, okay? Whatever you do in your private life, go right ahead. I don't mind. But when you hit a girl and you blame it on porn, then that's where I draw the line, and that's when I want to kill. And that's when I get mad and I want to kill people.
Yeah, well, don't kill anybody. But, you know what, there's a lot of things out there that... people blame on everything else. They never look at it by themselves. They always say, hey, I see this too done and that done. Nobody gets blamed for it or nobody gets caught. And all of a sudden they get caught and says, why should I have gotten caught? What about all these other people that are doing it? This is, well, number one, you should have never done it in the first place, because that's the dumbest thing to do in any case. No woman, no one deserves to get abused in any type of situation. And now, when they do blame porn, says, "Hey, you can't blame porn when you're the one who did it."
And I understand completely if a porn star calls me up saying, "Why are you dissing porn?" I'm not dissing it. I don't care if you see two girls kissing or a guy and a girl having sex on porn sites, I don't mind. But I don't mind whatever floats your boat. Literally, I don't care. But when I see a girl getting hit by a guy because of porn videos, and the guy says, "Oh, I'm making excuse," and he makes so many excuses, because that's when I get mad. That's when I wanna scream.
Well, just don't do it. They'll probably videotape that too.
Porn is news to degrade women. Yeah, you're right. It is degrading to women, but the question is, if a girl stops being a porn star, if a girl stops doing porn, could they find another job?
Of course. It all depends on society, because some people say, "Hey, this gal's a porn star, let's hire her, maybe we can get some action off her." That's the kind of mentality that's out there. That's the problem. They have to understand it. You can't do all the things you want to do with a porn star, because they are individuals. They are a human being, and if you take whatever action there is to them and they don't want it, they can sue your ass. They can take you to court. I would rather see a woman if she wants to do porn, more power to her. Mm-hmm. But make sure that she protects herself or her family, because a lot of people get that do watch porn think it's okay to do this and do that, and it's really not. It can't be. There's so much things against the law that are going on that unfortunately happens. And the porn industry, they make over $1 billion, even more than $1 billion a year. And that's the big draw. It's all that big money that's coming in from people that do it. And I've talked to at least a couple of porn actresses in my lifetime, doing the trade shows and whatnot, and they regretted it. They actually regretted doing it, because it ruined their life for something that they wanted to do in the long run. Like one girl wanted to become a lawyer. And she applied for the bar and everything else like that. And this was after she got out of porn. They took one look at her and says, "I'm sorry, that the quality and standards of our company does not allow past porn stars in, and I don't care what kind of grades you got and everything else like
okay,
that."
Okay, time out. I'm sorry. What? Seriously? You are going to look at this girl that wants to do a stinking good job and going to say no? Are you serious? What is this lawyer's company? I swear to God that today's society is a bunch of idiots.
Yeah, of course. There are many idiots out there. But you know what? The people that give ex-porn stars a chance to develop themselves into a working society that is honorable and everything else like that, they can go on. Those people that accept what their past is, that since they cannot change it, but they can help in developing their future in and away from those porn industry. It all depends on what society does.
Uh-huh.
A lot of these crazy ass companies, they look at your past like, okay, since you guys stole the candy bar since when you were 8 years old, you cannot work in our company because we're afraid you might steal.
It's funny, because if I ever have if I start my own company called Annie's Productions for You, and a porn star actress comes to my neck of the woods saying, "Can I get a job?" I'm going to let them have it. I don't care what the past is. The past is the past. The future is the future.
Of course.
I don't care what you've done. I don't care what you've done for the past few years. I don't care if you rape a person or you rape a person or you had sexual assaults with a person. I don't care. The past is the past. Let's look for the future.
Exactly. And to accept somebody for who they are, not because of their past, you know, it's something that everybody should look at. It's okay, you had a bad past. We're going to shove all that to the side. We're going to look from what you are here and what you are there, and we'll develop something that's good for you, because everybody deserves a second chance. Third chances, that would be questionable.
Yeah, third chance. I would have to agree with you. If someone, a third chance, I would have to agree with you. Then I would have to take action. But you know what? The past is the past. The present is the present. It's interesting because each person has to take responsibility for their own actions.
Of course.
And it's funny because everybody needs to take action. They cannot blame somebody. Or they cannot blame somebody that, oh, let's say that you are a hot girl, okay? Let's say that you're a girl, okay?
Let's say that Amanda B is the girl, because I'm definitely a guy. I walk with something.
Okay, sorry. Let's say that Amanda B is is the hottest girl ever, and let's say that I had sex with her, okay? This is hypothetically, okay?
Okay.
And her husband caught me with her. What would I say, oh, Amanda forced me on her, or would I take responsibilities for my actions, saying, excuse me, I'm sorry, it was my fault. I thought Amanda was attractive, so I'm sorry that I had sex with her. Would the guy take the consequences, would punch me, or just talk to me? What would you do in that situation?
Well, first thing I do is I divorced my wife because she let it happen. And the second thing I do, this is if I have seen your face again, make sure you have a body bag in your pocket.
Mm-hmm.
That's what might be my my problem to be for me. But everybody deserves to live. Everybody deserves to have their say. This is okay. Say what you gotta say, then get out of my face.
Someone was pointing me to a porn site one time, and I went on it by mistake. Okay.
Yeah.
I'm sorry. I was trying to do research for what I was gonna do on my show, and I looked under the you know those comment button. Comment things that you can read the comments.
Yes.
These comments were so degrading to women that I wanted to throw up. One comment says, I would fuck her. Another comment would say, I would F her up so hard that her ass would be a brand new part of it. And another one was so disturbing that I almost threw up. The third one says, I would have sex with her, and I would make her ass bleed and her vagina bleed too. That's how bad these comments were.
Yeah, abusive is no way to go.
And I looked at these guys, and I wanted to say, are you serious? Are you kidding me? And Jonathan said in my chat room, they make $1,500 per scene, porn stars. And then it says this, but you are degraded and used and humiliated. Yeah, you're right. I would love to get a porn star on here one day. I would. And ask them, would you do it again? I swear to God, half of the porn stars will say no, right?
Some of them might go back.
depending on their situations at hand. Some people are nymphomaniacs, where they like sex all the time. They might as well get paid for it. That's one of their responses would be. Another person would say having sex on film, it just gives you some exposure. But if anything comes up in their private life that happens to, like, if they ever got a new relationship that doesn't want it, they'll go along with the relationship and drop the porn, period. Mm-hmm. There's a lot of people out there that have different views on it. Like me, I have three different type of views.
I'll be right back. I have to get news to back. Why don't you talk about those three views? I will be right back, okay?
All right. The three different views that I have on porn is one. Number one, people are doing it for money. Everybody needs to earn their way, and sometimes porn does do it. It may be degrading and everything else to some cultures and everything else, but in people's lives, some have no choice. They have to develop their own sense of well-being and processing everything else that goes along with it. There is always a way that a porn star can dictate their own lives throughout it all. And there's a lot of scripts that have been torn away from that, rejected because of the dangers involved. And there is number two, my view on porn, the possibility of having some SDCs, which, SDS, or you know what I'm talking about, sexually transmitted diseases. There's always that risk. There's always that type of things going on. Even though they have the doctors to check them out, they have this and that going for them, they have the best health care in the world, especially when it comes to porn, the porn stars. And there are careless people there, which is my third point. There are careless people in porn industry that will forego on doing any of the testings for STDs, sexually transmitted diseases. It doesn't matter to them because all they want is that sexual gratification. And unfortunately, it does damage families when an STD is transmitted. That's my 3 points.
Sorry.
Well,
you need some popcorn.
Oh, chow down, bro. I'm just sitting here and looking at my water bottle going, I'm not going to drink water. I'll probably
go right ahead. Drink some water here. We'll be right back on the Andy Bond Show. This is Ronnie Atkins from the Starter. We'll be right back on the Andy Bond Show. If you have any opinions on this, feel free to call into the show or type in the chat boxes if you have any opinions on this, okay? We'll be right back on the Andy Bond Show. And this is the Spreaker News. We'll be right back. He is former starter Ronnie Atkins.
Well, I heard he needed some help on the farm. Somebody with a truck and two strong arms, not scared of dirt and willing to work till the sun goes down. So I pulled up and said, I'm your man, I can start right now. And we shook hands. He said, the fence needs fixing, the beaches need picking, and the cows need bringing round. I was hauling hay, I was feeding the hogs, and that summer sun had me sweating like a dog. So I cooled off in the creek. Then it was back to work, and at that come heat, I was cussing out loud, thinking about quitting. Looking back now, I'm sure glad I did. 'Cause just when I thought it couldn't get no hotter, I caught a glimpse of the farmer's daughter. She was was just getting home from Panama City. She was all tanned up and my kind of pretty. When her eyes met mine, I was thinking that I sure love my job. As the days got shorter, our talks got longer. The kisses got sweeter and the feelings got stronger. So we'd hop in the truck and get all tangled up every chance we got. We were down by the river all night long. When the sun came up, I was sneaking her home and dragging my butt to work. With the smell of her perfume on my shirt, I'd be on the tractor, she'd be on my mind. With that sun beating down on his back of mine, and just when I thought it couldn't get no hotter, I fell in love with a farmer's daughter. We got married last spring. Whoa, and there ain't no better life for me. I'm still hauling hay and feeding the hogs, and that summer sun's got me sweating like a dog. So I cool off in the creek, and she brings me out a glass of sweet iced tea. Now I'm on the tractor, she's on my mind, and I can't wait till it's quitting time. And just when I think it can't get no hotter, I come home to the farmer's daughter. Yeah. The farmer's daughter.
This is Alpha Dog, and you're listening to The Andy Bong Show, only on Spreaker.com. Wonderful, 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 wonderful. Don't smoke, don't litter, don't step on a beetle or land. They're always working the sidewalks, never tread on the grass.
Hello, and welcome back to The Andy Bong Show, and we're talking about the porn industry and... And Grandpa Al, just coming up on the last music break, what the 3 points are. And if you want to call into the show or you have any opinions on the Skype chat on the subject, please, please, please feel free to call in. I'm not, because Grandpa and me are gonna, me and Grandpa are here just to tell you what we feel. We're not here to say you gotta stop watching porn, it's bad for you. We're just here telling your opinions. I swear to God, someone is gonna call me up and saying, I swear to God, when this podcast is done, people are gonna be typing in my chat by saying, why are you being mean to me, to us? What do you think, Grandpa?
Well, I feel that everybody has an opinion, and everybody's welcome to it.
So what was the 3 points? So the fourth point was...
There is no fourth point, but I can make one up.
It's the first point.
Sorry. The first point is that the porn industry would help those in need of money to get going on their education, getting their lives back together after a financial tragedy. And they do have incentive programs with porn to get out of it and continue their life on a road to financial success through other means.
Mm-hmm.
The second point, yeah, of course, Jonathan, of course you are degraded and used and humiliated.
What?
In some cases, that's what he said in the chat room.
Where?
Oh,
okay.
That one, yeah, I see that shit, yeah. But the second point would be there's a lot of things that it is degrading.
Amen.
In both sections, both men and women, because they are put through the ringer. And if the person does not want to do a certain scene or anything like that, they can reject it. They would have to write something else around it. But it all depends on, the young lady that says it's a personal choice. They have choices that they can make and break. It's something that's written out for adults, of course. But unfortunately, another thing about this is that young kids are starting to find porn sites.
Don't get me started on that.
I know.
Oh my God. I swear to God that our society is going down to shit. Because now we don't... That's the funny thing is, we don't have... Where's the parents? When I was a kid, if I got on some bad sites, oh my God, my dad and my mom would spank the living daylights out on me.
No, my parents always sent me over to grandma's house with her Lysol. Got stuck in my mouth a couple of times.
Oh,
I never liked to swear anyway.
Me either.
Swearing doesn't make you a man or a woman. It makes you a verbal idiot at times.
But kids are getting onto these porn sites now. And the funny thing is, I swear to God that one of these, have you ever seen these porn sites? Like I said, I've been on these porn sites before doing research. I'm sorry, I do. The funny thing is, I would go to a porn site and I would do research. How do you think I know so much about this crap? Because people have led me to these porn sites. Saying, hey Andy, check this out. And I'm like looking at them saying, are you serious? Are you stupid, man? And the funny thing is, they do not. And I'm like, what the heck is going on? Why is it that young men and women are getting onto porn sites now? Why?
Because they think that's a way to learn about love and sexual pleasures.
Hello, that's not how you learn about love.
I know that.
You learn about love by the way people act and the way people treat you. For example, let's say that me and you are best friends, okay?
Yes.
And I met you, we've been friends for a long, long time, okay?
Mm-hmm.
And so I tell you one of my deepest secrets, okay?
Mm-hmm.
And you want it, and you blab it out to somebody. Would that make me friends with you again or not?
Hell no.
Because
a secret between two people is supposed to be a stayed a secret. Period.
Mm-hmm.
It's an honor and respect thing.
Yeah.
I'm 56 years old, and my wife was the first person I've ever been with, and we've had six kids, five are living, and we have now seven grandkids with those children. So you know, it's a blessing to me, and then I found out that when I was in that porn stage that I wanted to see it and experience it and everything else, it's everything that I already knew from the person I was with. So why even worry about what's going on to porn? It's like a snooze fest.
Yeah.
And they come out with these the things like the fisting or using vibrators and everything else. Hey, well, it's experimentation.
Yeah. I understand. You know what? Have you ever heard of those fucking machines?
Oh, yeah.
Those things, I don't mind those whatsoever. I don't mind those. That's the funny thing is, I don't mind those.
Why?
Because a man is not doing it to them. A machine is, and you can't get transmitted diseases from it.
Oh, yes, you can if you had one person use it before them.
You can?
Oh, yes.
Okay, whoa.
There is no way to completely remove a sexually transmitted disease if they have never used protection with those machines.
Interesting. Sorry. See, I'm learning something new. But why is it that people, why does it that guys give sexual transmitted diseases to girls and do the same thing? Why?
Yeah, it works both ways.
Yeah.
If they're not careful, if they don't get checked, if they don't have the ways or the means of making sure that they prevent themselves from having infected sex with somebody else, the guys that have this infection, they don't give two craps. They just go ahead and bang the ladies for the enjoyment, the pleasure, and the jacking off on them.
Oh, but, yeah, hello.
Yeah,
you know what? Can that something? I don't think guys have a problem with porn. I'm sorry. How many guys in your lifetime would, if I asked the same question, would you do porn to fuck a girl? How many guys would say yes?
Probably 95% of them. Only 5% has any type of morals.
I have morals too, and I'm saving myself for marriage. I'm sorry. I have morals too, you know. I am a Christian boy. I can tell you I'm a Christian boy, and I do this crap. I do research on this crap every single time so I can get more knowledge, because when someone comes on saying, oh, porn is good, I can show them what I know. So I do knowledge on it. Knowledge is power.
Oh, of course.
So basically, if anybody ever says that porn is good for you, yeah, right. Just take a look at the girls. The girls are... Some girls love it, some girls hate it. 95% of the girls like it. Or 50, what do you think? 50 or 90?
The 95, I think the 95% is the ones that are doing it mostly for the money. 5% doing it because they love to do it. And another... Oh, I would say if you're rounding everything out to 100, it would be 90% of the girls do it for the money. 5% would do it because they're just loving the fact that they can do it.
Uh-huh.
And they're getting it the way they want, and they're getting paid for it. But mostly they love the prestige of being able to screw a guy's brains out and get them excited and everything else like that. But the 5% that do not do it, they said it's immoral acts and everything else like that, know their own bodies.
Uh-huh.
It's a choice that they wanted to make. It says, hey, I don't want to do this for this or this. I want to do it for the person that I'm in love with. That's it. Nothing more.
The porn industry, I have to admit, the porn industry is now cracking down on people that are taking advantage of this.
Oh, of course.
I have to say that I am so proud of the porn industry. Those words are never going to leave my mouth again. But right now, I am proud of it because they're cracking down on people that are taking advantage of it. Are basically taking advantage of it, correct?
Exactly, yeah. They are.
And they are taking advantage of it. I'm not kidding you. I swear to God that I went on a website one time, and I was reading this article, and the article says, and this girl, this undercover girl from the newspaper, did a story under it, and it's, and the title was the funniest title ever. Is the producers and the directors taking advantage of helpless girls? And so this girl went undercover and wrote the story. And two people knew about it. The owner of the company. The owner of the company knew about it. Okay?
Yeah.
And the second guy, and there was a girl that was working for prep. You know, those girls behind the scenes that get stuff ready for them, like makeup?
Of course.
So that was the other girl that was on it, because if anything happens, the girl had a walkie-talkie and, like, a ear, you know those earpieces that they use for Secret Service?
Yeah.
Yes.
There was a walkie-talkie in this guy's, the earpiece in this girl's, this makeup star's ears, and it was directed to the owner. And so if anything happens, the thing that the girl says, owner of the porn star industry, can you come down and help? So they had it. And so anyway, the article went on to say, I've been around porn industries and 95% of the directors take advantage of hopeless girls.
Yep. Well, unfortunately, that does happen too. Somehow, some way.
Goodbye, Nikki. Have a nice day, Diamond Nikki. I hope you come back to the show. Thank you so much for joining us. Peace out. Love ya. That kind of stuff. Love, prosper. That kind of stuff. Okay, go on.
Yep. There are things that do happen where they will take advantage of the people, but you can't. You can't dictate that how many people will do it or how they get people find out on how they find these women and everything else like that. Most of it is staged. But the portions that are not staged, they take people off the street. Like, if you've ever heard of the Bang Bus.
The Bang what?
The Bang Bus. It's called a Bang Bus.
Never heard of it.
The guys run around in a van with windows exposed and everything else like that. They pick up unsuspecting girls and they convince them to take their clothes off and go and screw this guy in the Bang Bus, recording it and whatnot. They drop them off in a rural area where they don't know where they are. And just leave them there and laugh as they turned off.
Oh my God.
Yeah. So, yeah, there's a lot out there that women have got to little be wise. And then us guys definitely have to find these idiots and teach them a lesson. But
I know.
It doesn't work that way.
I know. I was at one of the high school and why am I talking in a British accent now? I'm sorry, pull my finger that you're too young for this show. I'm sorry.
I'm an old man, so that's okay. We'll figure this one out later.
I'm sorry. Oh, pull my finger. I am so sorry. I gotta realize that we have kids in this chat room.
You didn't tell me that?
Hello, I did not know there was a kid in the chat room. I'm sorry. I should have put the Dane Explicit sign on. I'm sorry. If you heard this, pull my fingers, child. He knew every word in that cuss. I'm sorry. Okay, anyway, let's go on. Thank God he's leaving. I should ban him. I'm going to ban him right now. I'm just banning him, okay?
What's pure? I just lost my virginity listening to Andy Bosch.
Are they just joking with me, or are they serious?
You gotta take things with a little grain of salt, no matter what people say.
It is funny. Okay, now we have that. Wow, okay. Everybody grab a girl and have sex with them, because Danny Marshall says. I'm joking.
I learned a long time ago not to stick to my privacy.
In a nasty place. Interesting. Anyway, go on. What was that?
When you're about 5 years old and trying to stick a fork in a light socket, yeah, that's a bad thing, too.
Yeah. So you were talking about something about... Where were we? Oh, the Nimbusters.
Yeah. Actually, it's called Bang Bus. Yeah. But they have episodes out there where they actually treat the girls like queens until they do their act, and they throw them out of the bus anywhere in the place where they can get raped or killed or anything else like that. It's weird.
That is sick.
Yeah.
I'm sorry. Bang Bus. I know this is gonna be funny, and I don't condone violence. But if you ever see this Bang Bus in your neck of the woods,
shoot it.
No, actually, don't shoot it. Go to the stinking guy and pound the living daylights out of it, and then shoot the bus. Shoot the tires and call the police if you see this stinking Bang Bus in the stinking street anywhere in the United States. If they're listening to my show, God, I hope they are. If you ever come to my neck of the woods, I don't care if I own a gun or not. I will get somebody that owns a gun, and I will call the police. So beware, you son of a bitch.
Hey, Jonathan said he, not him. It's he has a beautiful wife.
I know.
You're blessed with a beautiful wife.
Oh, of course. Yeah. You see these guys with beautiful wives, and they want to fuck something else. What the heck?
Yeah, some people don't have that special.
I'm sorry, if I had a beautiful wife by my side, and I would, and I'm sorry, I would be the luckiest man ever.
Well, I married a beautiful woman. She's been part of my life for 38 years, and definitely I have one thing to say about her. She's a fart machine at night. And she goes to sleep, and she farts in the night. The dogs stick their nose on her butt just to sniff what she's got, and it's the funniest thing in the world. But I still love her, even though she's a big mouth lady. But yeah, definitely, I love that kid.
It's so much fun because you could the funny thing is you could have left your wife for something better, right? You could have left your
opportunity. Yeah.
Yeah, but you know what? It's interesting. Because you don't leave your wife because you love her very much. And that's why, this is why, Okay, what does PROCCBIED stand for? Pre-Cupid? Pre-Cupid?
Pre-Cupid.
What's that?
P-I-D.
I'm going to put that thing in the Skype channel because I have no clue what the heck this is, okay? And maybe you can help me, okay?
Preoccupied.
Preoccupied.
Preoccupied. In other words, they have something else to do.
Oh. Yeah. I don't have nothing else to do. I love talking. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. Do you forgive me, everybody, that I'm doing this?
No. Go ahead.
Anyway, and you just wonder why these guys want these Bang Bus, and you wonder why they do it.
They do it to get their rocks off. That's it. And then they video post it. They don't know how much problem that could happen. But the thing is, if the girl accepts the challenge and does it in that bus, there's nothing illegal about it.
Let me go on to YouTube. Bang Bus. Is it B-A-N-G-B-U-S?
Yeah, B-A-N-G-B-U-S. Now, Gasoline said, I'm looking for a woman that's beautiful on the inside.
Oh, my God. Okay, I got this.
All women are beautiful.
Oh, my God.
You know what the best way to find...
Oh, my God.
Yeah.
Oh my God in heaven, I'll be your name.
I think I'm going to stop talking.
I'm sorry. Listen to this. You want to hear what they are. Here are the two people that are talking right now. Here it is. Presenter Parker talks about Bang Bus Law Program. Mm-hmm. Cameraman is head of Bang Bus talks openly about the problems that Bang Bus is having with the law. Oh, you want to hear that?
Go ahead.
Let's see what the law has. Okay.
Yeah, no. Tony was asking us about all the good footage that we don't get to show the audience. He doesn't even know, does he?
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, let me say this right now. Bad boys, what you gonna do? What's you gonna do when the law comes for you? Let's finish this. Ladies and gentlemen, the Bane Bus law problems have just begun. This girl that did a footage with this told the police, and thank God. Thank God, here it is some more.
Well, some days we talk to 20 girls. Sometimes they come with us, and then we find out they don't have their ID or something else, and we can't talk about that right now. Yeah, sometimes you're not allowed to show violence.
And you're okay, seriously?
Yeah.
And you're laughing at this? You son of a bitch! Sorry.
Sorry.
Oh my God, they're laughing at this.
Of course.
They have no morals whatsoever. They're morons.
Until the long arm of the law grabs them and pulls them in jail.
Oh man, I wish they could. Oh man, you know what? When the law comes up with them, I would want to be front row center to that court. I would have my laptop with the Spreaker news people on this thing faster than he is a hot dog on a stick. I'm just wondering, why can't they put a sting on these guys? Police put stings on everybody else. Why can't they put a sting on this thing?
They don't need to put a sting on it. They videotape this stuff and put it out there. So they've got plenty of evidence to go by. The problem is, they will not show all the things that they do. They do all the illegal stuff and put that out, but they will not show the illegal stuff.
I just wonder if you get a camera guy in, if the camera guy disappeared and you, I wonder if they have that footage that they did with the legal stuff, like illegal stuff. I wonder if they have that.
They probably do, but probably in a private stash where nobody can find it.
That's what should happen. That's what the police should do. Get a stinking warrant.
Of course.
And search for it, because these guys drive in a bus, in a van. I can see the van, okay? I can see the van right now. And I know that they have a place of operation. You have technology now. You have drones right now. Why can't you just put a drone on this Bane bus and follow it to their, follow it to their hideout? Why?
They actually don't have a hideout. They do it right out there on the street, inside the van.
I know, but where's the stash? If they have secret stash, where are they?
Well, it could be all over the city, because that's what they do. It's usually through the Encino area, California. They've gone from as far north as Hollywood and far south as right along the border of California and Mexico.
This is so stupid. And you don't, and these guys do not know what they're doing to these young girls. They're going to get raped or killed. And they don't give a rip.
Oh, they know what they're doing. It's just.
And they don't give a rip.
Yeah, they don't.
They just want to have a fun time. And you're like, seriously?
That's what some people do.
Let me finish the story before I. And then I'm going to stop it, like, for, this is a 12-minute, 54-minute video, so we're going to stop it in 10 minutes, okay? And we can discuss about it, okay?
All right.
Ladies and gentlemen, if you are so hype on this one, listen to this, and we will talk about it later.
I've had 10 minutes. I've had broken cameras. We've been in accidents, and I didn't have the camera rolling. Or we couldn't show it. Yeah, no, that's true.
Yeah, sorry, we didn't show the 70 miles an hour to a toll booth.
Oh, shit.
Yeah, that was crazy. Okay, because you know you go 70 through Sun Pass, right? But we're coming back from Orlando, and the Sun Pass is in the middle of the, you know how those Sun Passes, sometimes they're in the very middle,
yeah.
And you have to slow down 20, went through it right through it, 70.
Yeah.
We had like an inch before killing ourselves. It was horrible. What about all the girls? You know, that's the thing. That was a good question. because you know, for audience here, sometimes all the time now, we go straight to the girl that we pick up, because the other girls that we talk to or we pick up, we're not allowed to show them anymore because they have to give us their ID and shit.
Tell them
about
the lady.
No. No, you know what? I'm going to be honest with you.
She had teeth, but then she just took them out.
Okay, wait. You ready to hear this? I lost the footage. I've lost so much footage through the years. You lose, you run out of memory cards, and then, I don't know, it's stupid. It's easy to do. Now everything is digital, it's not like tapes. But we have picked up some really hot girls. And we ask them if they're 18, they're like, yeah, like, give us your ID. I don't have it on me. I'm like, you gotta give us your ID, please. You know how much money I've lost? I had one girl take $300 out of my hand walking on the street, and she just kept walking. And it was a good video, too, because I got out. I practically harassed her, and she called the police. She called the police. Wait, listen. She called the police, and she's saying that I'm harassing her, and that she doesn't have anything of mine, and there's a big camera in her face, and I've asked her to take off her clothes. And I didn't even ask her. I'm like, you know what? Normally I would, but I didn't even do that. You know what's it called when that happens and you have it coming because...
Karma?
No. Why? Okay, yeah, but she knew what was going on. It's like, okay, have you ever been arrested? Of course, both of you have. And you're thinking, man, I've done a much fouler shit than this and I didn't get arrested. Why am I getting arrested now? That's how I felt when she took my money and kept walking.
Hey, Grandpa, are you still with us? Sorry. Okay, let's stop right here where I decided to stop it right there. So what do you think about this? Okay, so the cops have this on YouTube, on everything here. And they cannot find a reason to arrest them?
Well, it's unfortunately, there are holes in the law where they say that a person that gives their a consent... it's perfectly legal.
Okay, seriously. And these guys, these bang bus guys, are just the worst of the worst. And they don't give a rip. They will treat her like princesses, and then they will throw them out like... They will throw these girls out like a piece of trash in these war areas where gangs are affiliated, or where, or somewhere in a... area where gangs run Riley, and the only thing that these gangs want are hot girls, basically.
Yeah, basically. And then the unfortunate thing is that when they do crazy stuff like that, it's just something that they do. And unfortunately, women are not a little bit more informed about what's going on. And they fall for it.
You know what? Let's do right now. Let's tell all these, if these girls are listening to these podcasts later, tell, okay, everybody in my chat room, I know that you're listening. I want you to put this thing on a recording right now because I'm going to say this once and you can listen to this podcast over, but I'm going to say this once. And you can put this on recording. You can give this thing to any girl that you heart desires. Go. You know those guys that hell that say that Jesus is coming, you're going to hell, basically? Those evangelists, you know those guys?
Mm-hmm.
That say you're going to hell if you don't repent?
Mm-hmm.
Record those tapes and hand them out at your local high school, local college, local anything ever, because you can. Ask the dean of students to see if you can hand these things out at your local high school and your students, and record what I'm going to say. If you are trapped between a hard place and a guy offers money for sex, do not do it. These guys on TV, these bang buster people, they will throw you out. They will treat you like princesses, and they will throw you out like a piece of trash in a war area where gangs run wild, and the only thing that gangs want are pretty girls to F up. So please, 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 do not do this. Do not, if you see a van coming, call your local police, okay? If someone stops and says, hey, pretty girl, hey, you want to come in? Call the police. The police is there to do something, right? Right?
Sometimes
and sometimes not. And if you are feeling threatened, tell somebody. Tell a person that is walking with you saying, excuse me, can you please help me? These guys are being mean to me. Can you help me? And most of the people will do it. There is some human people. There is some human interaction in some people. Right?
Yeah, definitely.
So ask these people to help you, because only you can protect yourself. Only you can be heard. You can stand up to these bane bus people, okay? And I'm going to say this once, if these bane bus people are hearing this on YouTube, on my Spreaker account, I'm going to say this once and once over. If you come to my area, I will hunt you down and I will kill you.
Yeah, don't want to do that.
Why?
You can definitely get yourself in trouble by even saying that.
Okay, never mind. Let me rephrase that.
Yeah, please do.
Let me rephrase that. Sorry. Too bad we don't have an erase button. Let me rephrase that. I will come to your butt. I will come to you. If I see your bus, I will shoot the tires out. Okay?
Very good.
I will shoot the tires out, and then I will call the police on you. And trust me, I know more police officers in my small town than you know in your lifetime. Let me rephrase that even more. I know more police officers. More police officers are my friend than they are yours. So basically, in layman's terms, trust me, you do not want to mess with me or my town. Basically, yeah. Because I don't take this crap. I don't.
Gasoline says, ladies, carry a gun. Definitely.
Yes, amen. Amen. They have safety courses out there for girls to learn how to take a gun. Don't walk in a dark area. Correct. There is some great guidelines for girls. Don't walk together as a group. Don't get separated. It feels like I feel like I'm talking to kindergartens, but no, it's true. If you're a girl and you're walking alone in a dark alley, have somebody coming along. If your car is parked far away, let's say that on 56th Street in New York City, I don't know if they have a 56th Street. But if your car is parked on 56th Street, have someone walk with you to your car and be safe. And the piss and coward guys who abuse women and little bullies. Amen. Anyway, walk. Don't walk in dark areas. Walk by yourself. Carry guns. We have the right to carry guns, ladies and gentlemen. We have concealed carry laws in states here, right? Right?
Yep. Thank God.
We do have a real man will love and take care of a woman, protect them, and not abuse them. Amen, Jonathan. Amen. Preach it, brother. All we're saying is that you can make a difference. If I'm praying to God, if you have girls listening to this one, if you have teenagers, tell them to listen to the show. Tell them. If you're a father of your own, tell your daughters to do it. tell your dollars to listen to this show because it's going to help you in the long run. I'm not here to make a profit. We're not here to make money, right? We just do this because we want to, right?
Of course.
And we're telling you the truth here. We're not making money. We're not going to sell you anything. This is real. These are the real comments that people are reading right now. These are the real comments. We're not making this up. We are not paying these people to act like this. These are real people and real emotions here. When you hear me choke up on this, I swear, when I said, oh my God, I can't believe this, I almost cried. I almost cried on live radio. Because I hate this crap. I hate when punk ass people, when pump ass people put stupid crap on the computer. That's what I feel. I feel mean. I feel pissed off right now because I really want to do something. And we're not doing this. And Alpha Draw says, John, the reason I challenged him is because he could whip anyone. I found that that is always someone faster to draw. Okay. I have no clue what the hell, blah, blah, blah. Oh, sorry. Anyway, what we're saying is don't. If you are a human being, don't be mean to girls. Don't be mean to anybody because you can do it. I know you have a heart, and I love this one. A real man will never pick on or hurt someone that is weaker. Whether it be a woman, child, or animal, or another weaker man. That's amazing.
Truly well spoken.
That is amazing. Alpha Drain, thank you for tuning in here. Thank you for tuning in. Ladies and gentlemen, let's finish this, okay? And we're going to come back for some more. So, I'm sorry, this is a 12-minute video, so I'm not even going to do this anymore because it's going to hurt my heart. Hey, Grandpa, I'm going to put my video chat on, I want you to see something.
Alright.
Am I really being honest right now?
Of course you are.
Look at my... Tell everybody what you're seeing right now.
I see your face and I see your eyes. You are telling the truth.
Every single time when I hear about this, I want to cry out because it's not fair for girls to go through this crap. Going through a living hell. I know how people feel. I know how people do. I know how people are going through living hell. I know how girls feel when they are abused, when they are when girls are abused, they go through hell. And you know what? I don't understand how girls do it, to tell the truth, to move on. I think girls are more braver than men. Because girls move on, and they move on with themselves. If someone raped a guy, they would just go into a downward spiral, correct? What do you think?
Those that are sensitive, yes, they would go into a downright spiral. The thing about it is, both men and women have this self-preservation thing. Like, they don't want to tell anybody when bad things happen to them. They would rather keep it to themselves and let it fester. The problem is, when it does fester, it leads to lifelong problems. And the best way to do it is to tell somebody, get the help you need, and it go on in life.
Mm-hmm.
Because if you have one real good person that you can talk to, and that person will guide you to wherever it needs to go. That's what angels do. We have angels walking here on earth at all times.
Ladies and gentlemen, Jonathan says a real man stands up for his beliefs. A peaceful till he has to fight for his family and those in need. Correct.
Absolutely. And,
correct. Ladies and gentlemen, I know that, and I know that rage comes out of you, and you're like, whenever something bad happens, your rage goes into like, okay, I'm going to hurt this guy. All of a sudden, you turn into this monster that you're not going to stop until you get what you're looking for, correct?
Correct.
You gotta turn off that monster, but sometimes you can't. Sometimes you cannot turn off that monster. Sometimes that monster goes into effect, and the only way to turn it off is to get that guy who hurt your daughter, who hurt your sister, who hurt your mom, who hurt your wife, that kind of stuff. And you know what? If anybody ever, I know that Gasoline has two daughters. I know that because he told me that. Okay, he told me that he has two daughters. I don't know how old her daughters are, and I'm praying to God that if they and if they ever grow up, I hope he saves this show and replays it for them. Because I'm giving these girls a lot of information.
Of course.
And you know what? Being around girls so many times in high school, trust me, I never had sex with them, but I swear to God that I wanted to. I wanted to. Scouts on, I wanted to have sex with them. I was ready to have sex with them. Sorry, to tell the truth, you're a guy. When you're a guy, your hormones go into different directions. When you're in high school, your hormones go into different directions.
When you're an old fart like me, everything goes to hell.
Yeah, basically. But I wanted to have sex with all these hot girls that came up to me. And trust me, there were some really, really, really hot girls. But I didn't. Because I realized I could be the guy that had sex with every girl and I could be mean to them for the rest of the life saying, you had sex with me, you're a slut, you're a whore. But I didn't have sex with them. I did not say you're a slut or a whore. I did not say that. Because half of the girls came to me saying, Andy, can you help me? And I always said, yes, of course I can help you. I always listened to their problems. I always talked to them. And these guys who had sex with these girls said, oh, I had the hottest sex with these girls. I said, oh my God, she was good in bed. She was screaming for their mama. Basically that. And do you know how hard it is for me not to lose my temper when I heard that in my high school?
I believe you have a nice temper that will blow off.
Trust me.
I know you respect other people.
Oh, too. Yeah. When I heard that with the guy, I almost wanted to punch the living daylights out of them. And the principal saw me, like, mad. And the principal says, Andy, can you come with me? And the principal says, I know that you're mad at this. I know that these guys are talking about this. I know these guys are. But you know what? You can't get mad. You can't get angry. And the principal always says this. And I'm going to live with these words. If you get angry and you go out hitting, what makes you better than those guys? Correct?
Correct.
If you start hitting these guys for this, what makes you more than a man? You're a wussy. And that's why I don't hit girls. This is why I don't, whenever I hear that, I tell a principal. I always do that because I don't want to be one of those guys that are mean to other guys. But every single time when I went through high school, I went through a living hell because of that. And I went through a living hell. Anyway, we'll be right back. We're going to take a short commercial break. Here's Country Girl Shake It For Me, and let's have a little bit of fun, okay? Let's let them off the party. We'll be right back on the Andy Bond Show.
Hey, girl. Oh, now. You know you got everybody looking. Boom in my big truck. Gonna open up the doors and turn it up. Gonna stomp my boots in the Georgia mud. Gonna watch you make me fall in love. Get up on the hood of my daddy's tractor. Up on the toolbox, it don't matter. Down on the tailgate, girl, I can't wait to watch you do your thing. Shake it for the young bucks sitting in the honky-tonks. For the rednecks rocking till the break of dawn. The DJ spinning that country song. Come on, come on, come on. Shake it for the birds, shake it for the bees. Shake it for the catfish swimming down deep in the creek. For the crickets and the critters and the squirrels. Shake it to the moon, shake it for me, girl. Oh, country girl, shake it for me, girl. Shake it for me, girl. Shake it for me. Country girl, shake it for me, girl. Shake it for me, girl. Shake it for me. Somebody sweet little farmer's child. They got a little blood to get a little wild. Ponytail and a pretty smile. Rope me in from a country mile. So come on over here and get in my arms. Spin me around this big old barn. Tangle me up like grandma's yarn. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Shake it for the young bucks sitting in the honky-tonks. For the rednecks rocking till the break of dawn. For the DJ spinning that country song. Come on, come on, come on. Shake it for the birds, shake it for the bees. Shake it for the catfish swimming down deep in the creek. For the crickets and the critters and the squirrels. Shake it to the moon, shake it for me, girl. Country girl, shake it for me, girl. Shake it for me, girl. Shake it for me. Shake it for me, girl. Shake it for me, girl. Shake it for me. Guitar. Like the river flows, feel the kick drum down deep in your toes. All I wanna do is get to holding you, and get to knowing you, and get to showing you, and get to loving you. Before the night is through, baby, you know what to do. Shake it for the young bucks sitting in the honky-tonks. For the rednecks rocking till the break of dawn. For the DJ spinning that country song. Come on, come on, come on. Shake it for the birds, shake it for the bees. Shake it for the catfish swimming down deep in the creek. For the crickets and the critters and the squirrels. Shake it to the moon, shake it for me, girl. Oh, country girl, shake it for me, girl. Shake it for me, girl. Shake it for me. Oh, country girl. Country girl, shake it for me, girl. Shake it for me, girl. Shake it for me.
This is Alpha Dog, and you're listening to The Andy Bong Show, only on Spreaker.com.
Wonderful, wonderful, wonderful. Don't smoke, don't litter, don't step on a beetle or lamb.
Thank you, Alpha Dog, for that nice promo, the Andy promo. You've been hearing that promo for the last few hours. And we are at the 79-minute mark, ladies and gentlemen. We're almost done with this show here. But we're going to keep on talking. So, what do you think? What do you think young girls should do? And wives and daughters, what should they do?
What should they do?
What should they do? Should they prepare themselves and arm themselves?
Of course. The parents of any kind of children should be as supportive as they can, because things that happen in school, sometimes they don't want to tell the parents on what's going on, and that's what some of these problems have been happening, especially when you have kids going into schools with guns, killing kids and teenagers and the teachers, because they either didn't get their way or they weren't properly prepared for life, or even have issues with bullies and everything else that they did not want to bring out. They thought they would be weak to bring anything out. But if you console your parents, and if the parents console into the kids and appreciate and love them for who they are and not be worrisome about what they have told you, but instead being worrisome about what they don't tell you, to talk about it. You sit down, talk to them as human beings, as family members, as the people that you love and you want to protect, and they got to know that, because most of the people that have done the shootings in these schools, they were never told that what to do, how to handle things the right way. They always thought and learned from these movies, these video games, and everything else on how guns can solve problems. That does not solve problems. It only causes more problems. Talking it out, and bringing it back to what you need to do is a lot more important than what they want you to do in the schools. Actually, the schools is what a parent should be talking to as well. There's a lot there.
Uh-huh. We have so much crime in the streets right now. We are talking about everything from porn to school shootings to everything. But let's take a side. Let's put a pause in this. Let's put a pause in this porn thing in for a little bit, and then we can wrap this thing up as a Christmas bow. But let's talk about why do you think guys have sex with girls? What do you think? Why does guys rape girls?
Why do guys rape girls?
Yeah. Do they think they want to be powerful or what?
Their domination. It's just something that their sex drive, they're not prepared to handle. They think, since you see it on the movies and on video games, it's okay to do, and they won't get in trouble with it. But the problem is, the reality slaps them in the face, and it should slap them even harder. Like, rape should be treated just as much as a murder should be. Yeah, the laws are too lax in their preparation for these things, and let's put it this way, if somebody does rape a girl or a girl rapes a guy, something should be done to either castrate the guy that has done the problem, or I don't know what to do about a woman, but I swear it's something's got to do to them in order for them to know, hey, it's not okay.
You know what? I am going to go where you're going, but I'm going to take it a step farther. If a man rapes a girl, the man should go to a prison for 5 years. If a girl rapes a man, then the girl should be thrown into jail. But seriously, okay, you hear these stories on girls having sex with a guy and a boy. if you hear that. And this one time I was watching a HLN. Have you ever heard of it?
Yes.
Have you ever seen the girl that was modeling and the pictures got out and the school board was so up in arms?
Oh, yeah. The problem, everybody has the right to do whatever they want to do to themselves. If they include somebody else in it, then that becomes a problem.
And then the guy was so mad because they were, the guy was so mad at the girl because they were having a, she was like, why are you doing this? And I'm like, seriously? You know who I'm talking about, right?
Yeah, I think so.
The girl that did the modeling and it was a kindergarten teacher?
Yeah.
You know what I'm talking about?
Yeah, I'm pretty sure I do.
Okay, good. Thank you. Because I really did not want to go off on bunny trail here. Because I want you to weigh in on this, but these girls who do modeling and who was a kindergarten teacher, and you know what? Who cares if they were models? And the teacher was so pleasant to these kids. She did not bring her in her professional, her modeling stuff into the school. Most girl teachers would. I'm sorry.
Unless they want to keep their anonymity. They want to have it in both of their worlds, their teaching and their modeling skills. We've been hearing more and more about teachers doing young boys because they think they're cute. And the problem is, it's a two-way street. The women are engaging into things with the young boys, older teachers, the men are doing that with young girls, and back and forth, girls on girls, boys on boys. Like I said, it's all because of what is being displayed on TV, on the video games, and everything else. They all think it's okay.
It's not. You're right. Why is it that video games are always part of it? We have videos, we have video games, and we're not blaming that. We're blaming video games and videos. We have proof of that.
Heck. Well, we shouldn't be blaming the video games themselves. It should be the message that it sends.
The message that I have a Nintendo GameCube and I play NCAA football and Madden football 2005, and I love it because who's that in the background?
Okay. That's Kyle, my grandson.
Cool.
He came in and said, meatballs are done.
Nice. Well, anyway, like I said, video games should be, what is the message sending them? There is so many bad video games that is out there today that are sending a bad message saying, if you rape a girl, you're cool. If you shoot somebody, you're cool. If you, if you have cigarettes, if you drink, if you do that, you're cool. If you rape a girl, if you rape two girls, you're cool. If you rape a teacher, you're cool. That kind of stuff. But it's not. It's uncool. Literally, it's uncool. I understand that teachers have a, I know how guy teachers are. They go in and they want to have sex with everybody because the girls are hot. And they put their blood, and they have their, the blood pressure goes up, okay? I understand that, okay? We had a teacher in our school that had sexual assault. And he was a good teacher of mine. And I could not believe what was going on. He was a great teacher of mine, and he was getting accused of having sex with a student in his car. And I had a great teacher. I had a wonderful teacher, okay? The basketball coach, the girls' basketball coach. He was so kind to everybody. He was so kind. And by gasoline. And it was so sad because Fox 11 News was there and they interviewed me. They put me on camera and I wanted to know what was going on. And they put me on camera saying, excuse me, do you know this teacher? And I said, yes. And the reporter says, did you know that he raped somebody? And I looked at the reporter and said, what? Seriously? Get your facts straight, dude. You're talking about my teacher here. The basketball coach. The girls' basketball coach, are you talking about him? You gotta be kidding. You must have your information wrong, you moron. And the news guy was astounded at me because I said that. And the news guy never heard that. They shut the video off on me. They did because I called him out. But the principal grabbed me. And the principal heard every word I was saying. And the principal looked at me saying, why did you say that? And I said, because we don't have the evidence. We don't have the evidence. Show me the evidence and I will believe you. And the principal says, I can't show you the evidence either. And I said, okay. The principal and me were in the same boat.
Yep.
And it was funny because I wanted to punch the reporter. And the reporter looked at me again because I was walking out of the principal. And the reporter says, excuse me, Andy, can I ask you a question off the record? And I said, yes. And the reporter says, Andy, I never heard anybody say that. Why did you say that to me? And I said, well, let me say I'm sorry. I did not mean to say it. My anger got the best of me. Do you forgive me? And the reporter says, yeah. The reporter looked at me saying, in all my years of broadcasting, I never heard someone say sorry. And I said, well, my anger got the best of me, so I'm sorry to you. If you want to do this interview again, go right ahead. And the reporter says, okay. So the camera was on, and the reporter says, Andy, tell me what you think about this allegation. And he read the allegation on his iPad or on his phone. And I said, well, what do you think? Do you think it's all right to have someone say he raped me? We don't know the facts. I don't know the facts. Principal doesn't know the facts. Nobody knows the facts. What happened? It's like he said, she said. Nobody knows the facts. And you gotta realize that facts are facts here. Once you show me the facts, I will believe you, okay? And so the reporter cut the camera off and I went back to my class. Not 5 minutes later, I swear to God, not 5 minutes later, the principal on the loudspeaker says, Andy Bowen, can you come to the office, please? And so the principal and I went to the office, and the reporter was there with no camera whatsoever. The cameraman went for lunch or something, okay?
Okay.
And the reporter looked at me saying, Andy, can I ask you some questions about Jesus? I'm like, what? The principal says that you know your dad is a pastor and you know questions about Jesus. And I said, of course. What's the questions? And I'm never going to forget what this guy says. And the principal was here too. We had the principal. We had a pastor. Thank God the pastor was there at our at the school. So it was me, the news guy, the principal, and the pastor. And the pastor was sitting there. The principal was sitting there. I was sitting by the news guy was sitting at a table. And I was sitting right by the pastor and the principal and the news guy, okay?
Yeah.
And the news guy asked me, Andy, can you tell me why you believe in Jesus? And I said, I can't tell you why I believe in Jesus. I just know that he lives in my heart. And the news guy says, okay. I got another question. I said, okay, ask me as many questions as you want. And it was like about 1 o'clock here. And this news reporter was asking me questions like no one out here. And it went on for like about like an hour, like 2:30, 3 o'clock, basically almost 2 hours. And I had to get to the bus. And he was bombarding me with all these questions about Jesus and how he can get to Jesus Christ. How can he get to the Savior? And the pastor was helping me out with the questions. I was saying something. The principal was saying something. And so not after about 2:30, the news guy looked at me saying, "Hey Andy, can you pray for me so I can accept Jesus into my life?" The pastor and me and the principal were like, all looked at each other like this. Our jaws dropped. The news guy looked at me, and finally the cameraman is recording everything what's going on here for posterity, okay? Yep. Camera guy was like, okay, let's do this. The camera guy believed in Jesus Christ, so he's like getting this on camera for the reporter to watch this again. The camera guy was like this, jaws dropped. I was jaws dropping. I was jaws dropped. The reporter said, "Can you?" And I said, "Of course." So we all, and I said this, okay, bow your heads. And the pastor, and I said, "Pastor, you want to lead him to Christ?" The news reporter says, "No, Andy, I want you to." And I said, "Sir, I'm not a pastor, but if the pastor whispers the words into my ears, I think I can help you." The pastor said, "Okay." And the pastor whispered the ears saying, "Jesus, please take this guy, ladies and gentlemen, blah, 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 the all, I give you my heart," that kind of stuff.
Mm-hmm.
That kind of a pair, I can't remember it. And all of a sudden, when we say amen, the guy's spirit was lifted.
Cool.
All the burdens that he had done was lifted. And the news guy, the camera guy, was recording everything. And the news guy was, the reporter was crying, I was crying, the pastor was crying, the news guy was crying, everybody was crying. And I said, "Can I have that video?" And I said, "I want you to put that video in a special place. And whenever a reporter wants to know Jesus, play that video." And I pointed to the news guy, and the news guy says, "Of course." And it was the coolest thing ever, because I led some, and the pastor and me were looking at each other and saying, "Yes, we led him to Christ." We were jumping up and down like we were jumping up and down, because I had to reach the bus and the pastor had his car. And this was when cars were like the fastest, like those cars that go 0 to 60 in 5.1 seconds. So the pastor is driving me, and all of a sudden you can hear the car doing like this, boom. I almost lost my life right there. So finally we made it to the bus. And I was like, "Okay, thanks." And the pastor says, "Good job, Andy," and just drove off.
Awesome.
So that's how you can do it. And talking about sex and talking about porn, and what we're talking about is that we can make a difference. We can educate kids on it. We can. I don't know how we can educate them on, but we can talk to them saying, "No, it's not right."
That's how you educate them.
That's how you educate them. If they don't believe you, they don't believe you. But you gotta be educated on it, because you got to know what's going on, what's wrong, what's right. And you see these people on. Take example of the Spain bus. You see this on YouTube. And I swear to God, let me look at something, okay?
Alright.
I'm gonna go do that Bane bus one more time and see how many followers they're having, okay? Sorry.
Bang.
Sorry.
No problem.
I said buzz, not bus. Sorry, oh. Pain.
That's alright.
Oh, never mind, I got it. So, I'm just a random guy trying to make people laugh or shout by playing video games. Some questions. Oh, okay, never mind. Bane bus. Sorry. Oops, I want Bane bus. Not Bane awesome. Buzz. Oops. Bane Bud started to the 26 minutes. I want to see this. Blah, blah, blah. Okay, Bane Bus download. GTA Online. Bane Bus episode 16. Liz, Jessica 1, AV. Wow. They have these guys on. Wow. Crud. I'm going to type in one episode, okay?
Alright.
This is Bane Bus, the Dark Zero Era. 97,050. Okay, stop. 97,053 hits. I want to see the comments. I'm sorry. I want to see the comments. You got anyone of the shit that was funny as hell. Seriously? Are you serious? You got any more of this shit? That was funny as hell. Oh, you gotta be kidding me! You piece of crap! Sorry.
That's right.
But this is a piece of crap! Oh my God in heaven! This is funny stuff. Can you do this again? Shut the hell up! This, KY01010. Shut the hell up! Oh, it's a reply. Someone replied. Oh, I can reply. I don't want to. Actually, I want to. I'm gonna reply. You are a piece of shit.
Hello, you.
If you think this is funny, you are a piece of shit. If you think this is funny, reply. Huh, I'm tired already. Let's see how long that will work. Now, let me go to another one. Daisy Summer, okay?
Okay.
Sorry. 2,481 hits. You gotta be kidding me. 2,481 hits? Literally? Seriously? Ah, crap, my computer is gonna freeze up again. Actually, I really don't want my computer to freeze up again.
I'm gonna be heading out to join my family for dinner, so I'm gonna have to bow out right now.
Okay, have a nice day.
Okay.
This is the Andy Barnes Show saying goodbye, goodwill, and I see you again later. Bye. And we're out of here. We're still talking, right? Cool. Sorry, my computer is froze up, so I'm going to keep talking here. This is just a piece of crap. Right now, I am looking at this and I swear to God that my blood pressure is gonna boil over, seriously. Sooner or later, my blood pressure is gonna boil over. We gotta stop this. We gotta stop the shit from YouTube. We gotta stop it. We got to stop it. We got to stop this shit. We got to. I'm sorry. And on a positive note, I will. We can make a difference. We just have to educate people. We gotta educate them on stuff, on everything. We gotta educate people, okay? We gotta educate people. I know guys are out there like saying, yeah, right. I'm gonna watch this shit. I wanna watch this crap. Don't do it, please. Don't do it. Please, please, please don't do it. Stop. You can stop it right now. My name is Andy Bond. The most hated guy ever. Goofy Bone, how are you doing? We gotta stop this crap. We got to. I know that people love sex, but... Hey, Goofy, how are you doing? You're live on the Andy Barnes Show.
Huh?
You're live on the Andy Barnes Show.
Oh, are we live?
Yeah, my computer freeze up, so I'm still talking here, ladies and gentlemen. So, yes, how are you doing?
What's up, everybody in Andy Bongville? I'm Goofy Bone. Just calling into my good friend show right here, just saying hello.
What is up? How are you doing? I do not hate you, Goofy Bones. I don't. I really don't hate you.
I hope not, man, because I'm getting tired of people saying that you hate me.
I'm not. Okay, who's saying that I hate you?
A lot of people.
A lot of people are saying that I hate you? Hate you? Yeah, right. Okay, seriously. Why would I hate you, Goofy Bone? We buried the hatchet on the news guy show. We buried the hatchet. Why would I be mad at you? I'm not.
Yeah, that's true. We did bury the hatchet. I really don't know, Andy, so...
People
don't
are...
Don't worry about it. In my eyes, we're good friends.
I know. People are just playing... I think they're looking for you because... You are the one that started this whole entire hate thing. And don't get me wrong, okay? Don't get me wrong. But people are looking for you that saying, okay, if we can get Goofy Bones to be mad at Andy again, we have him back on our side.
Well, yeah, I'm not mad at you, Andy. We're friends, so.
And we just said it out loud on the out loud on my show. We are friends. So what's new with you? I hear that you're gonna do a telethon. So I cannot wait.
Yeah, I'm doing a 24-hour marathon with all the rest of the people for the Wounded Warrior Project starting Sunday night, and then we're gonna go all the way one whole day until Monday night. So
I cannot wait. I'm looking forward to it.
Well, don't worry. We'll be there.
The funny thing is, you're going to have to... The funny thing is, I always do a show at 4 o'clock. So, that's going to be... That's going to be funny. Because my show is going to interrupt your telethon here. So, basically...
Don't worry, Andy. I'm pretty sure everyone's going to listen to your show. So...
You know what? You know what? I'm going to do something. You know what? This is going to be my... And you're going to hold me to my promise, okay?
Alright.
At 4 o'clock p.m., whatever the telethon is, I'm going to record it, okay? I'm not going to do a show. I'm going to do a 3-hour telethon. Whoever's doing it, I'm going to record it.
Okay, well, that sounds great.
You have to hold me to the promise because I know I'm going to forget on Monday. You know I forget every crap, right?
Yeah, so... Somehow, some way, people say that you do, so...
I don't know how I forget stuff, because I say on my show, and all of a sudden you say, you gotta replay your show, you said it. I'm like, okay, I don't remember saying it.
Yeah.
But I get so passionate about something that I forget. So, yeah, so what... So, are you doing a show tonight, Goofy Bone?
Of course we are. It's Saturday night's main event.
Oh, cool. What's the main event on?
That's what we call the show. It's Saturday night's main event.
So, okay, so the main event, so you mean set, oh, cool. So that is going to be interesting. I can't wait to hear that.
Yeah. But Andy, I just wanted to call you and say what's up. I'm going to take off right now. I got to go pick up somebody. So you have a great day, buddy.
You do too. This is the... Ladies and gentlemen, my name is Andy Bond, and this is the Warriors Fitness 18622 Scoopy Bones. So don't forget to listen to him, please.
Yes.
He is the coolest guy ever. We have some fun here.
Yeah.
So
right, Andy, I'll talk to you later.
Talk to you later, my friend. Okay, for some odd reason, my computer is locked up, so I'm going to shut this thing down. This is the Andy Bond Show saying goodbye, farewell, and see you later. And we're going to do a dance party next time on my show, so get ready to dance. So this is Andy Bond saying bye, peace out, love ya. We'll be back in about we'll be back at 7 o'clock p.m. Okay, so from all of us at the Green Bay Studios, my name is Andy Bond. Bye!